All right, so on that note, it's time for our next very insightful session. The question being, will BCCI kill GECs? Now, not very difficult in cricket-crazy country called India. So everybody like a sixer, put your hands together and let's have a huge round of cheer for Mr. Rahul Johri, the CEO of BCCI.
You know, I two things happened. I met Avinash the moment I entered. He said everything's running late, so we went to the bar before coming in. That's why we went here. But like Avinash, I had the opportunity of going to Aspen at one time. And before I reached, before you go for one of these courses, they send you a big questionnaire to answer. And we guys as Indians are used to answering yes, no. So when they actually analyzed the answers, I was the odd guy out who had extreme views, it came out, and everybody else on a scale of 5 was answering somewhere in between. It's just that at that time in Discovery, I was blowing all the targets. That's why I survived over there. Otherwise, I would have been a guy who would have been thrown out. Why I thought of that was that today when I was driving here and I was looking at the agenda, there were very extreme words in the agenda. You know, is the end here or is somebody going to get killed and things like that. But if you start thinking like that, then of course, I sit on the ICC committees, and some people say Test cricket is going to die. You know? But the answer was, if you think it's going to die, it'll die. But if you think it'll survive, it will. So I am not one of those with extreme opinions. I think that there is enough for everything to coexist. But having said that, I wanted to give you guys a bit of a glimpse of what the BCCI is all about. What is this animal all about? You know, you look at only cricket and you look at only the Indian cricket team. If you do your job well and a good product marketed well will deliver great results. But you look at the Indian team, thankfully, they're doing extremely well. And the one match I went for to Johannesburg, we lost. So now their superstition is that you're not coming for any matches anymore. But apart from that, apart from the Indian, we call it internally the senior men's team, because we have an under 21 team, we have an under 19 team who recently won the World Cup. We have an under 23 team, we have an A team. And on the women's side, we have a women team. Now we started a women's A team. So there is a lot of international cricket that we do. But what people don't realize is in the six-month cricket session that we have from October to March, the BCCI conducts more than 1,000 domestic games. And we manage 43 stadiums around the country where these games happen. And from the cricket center where I sit, the logistics of each of those games are being handled. So teams are moving, curators are moving, match referees are moving, everything is getting ready. And so it's a humongous operation. And what you see is the result of that operation, really, the culmination of that. And we produce 350 days of cricket for television, and which is about 2,500 hours of live content that we produce ourselves. All the production happens in-house. Now, the advantage of having production in-house is, and I worked in television before, I always used to cut my production guy's budget. But when we are doing production in-house, we are not dependent on a fixed budget. We are dependent on being first in every sphere. I'll give you an example. Last year when England was here, for the first time, Spider-Cam was used for test matches. And there was a journalist from Guardian who ran into me and said, you actually use Spider-Cam for test matches? And that's where now it's become the standard. We are looking at the idea of putting in zinc stumps at test matches. So as technology comes, we are embracing all the technology. The BCCI is a 90-year-old organization, but it embraces technology very, very quickly and has been at the cutting edge of innovation in terms of television broadcast or production. And so that's what, while, of course, we have some other parts to us apart from cricket operations, We are the biggest beneficiaries to the legal fraternity because everybody who has a view, if it's not heard of, files a case against us. But I'm here, you know, today I just wanted to focus on the media arm of the BCCI and what is it that we are doing to deliver all this value that you are all seeing. And like I said, so we are producing 350 plus hours. We have a production, the international matches we produce ourselves. The IPL is outsourced to IMG at the moment, but there's a new tender which is opening on Monday, so who knows who will be the next producer of the cricket matches, of the IPL. But I always believe that a good product marketed well will deliver the viewers and the consumers. And as advertisers, you will buy it when we deliver value. And that is the role cricket is playing today. The kind of investments like Sam said have been put in for cricket. What is it? What is that? That's a testimony of the belief people have in that content. Because that today we are at a cusp of change. I don't want to bore you with TV versus digital, etc. But which is the content which delivers value today and is future ready? Which is it that you see on your mobile phones, on your television screens, on every screen that possible? And that is cricket. That is the power of cricket. And you know, if you look at the IPL auction, which happened some time back, the media rights auction that happened some time back, and try and analyze it, the winner was stumped when I was there in the room, and when the winning group entered, they were completely stumped by a number that the digital company put in. Okay, we were estimating that the digital number would be between 2.5 to 3,000 crores, which would have been 10 times what we were paid in the previous 5 years. And suddenly, we see a number which was 1,000 crores more than that. Now, why are they putting that kind of number? What is happening? That consumption patterns are changing. And in the change of consumption patterns, what is that content which will deliver value at both times? Because you're thinking 5 years hence, nobody knows what will happen 5 years hence. And at the same time, what is the power of this content? I mean, the IPL is around the corner, and we are, most of the time these days, we spend a lot of time analyzing what do we want to do with this IPL. Now, what we want to do is, last year on day one, close to 100 million people tuned in to the IPL. Today we are saying, can we have a day one opening with 200 million? We are not talking about 1 TRP, 10 TRP, 5 TRP. We are not thinking like that. We are today looking at trying to create an event that will half the country watch it. So what we are targeting today is that if last year 500 million people watched the IPL over its 8-9 weeks, this year can we hit 500 million in week one? So that is the kind of ambition and level at which we are thinking. And you know, we have great partners, a great broadcast partner today, and both of us sit down once in a week and spend the whole day just thinking of plans to do these things. But this is the content which will drive value or drive engagement of that level. The other thing is, you know, from my television days, I remember that a lot of times we sit down in these meetings and talk, or these sessions, and talk advertising specific. But there's another facet to this entire business, which is called distribution. In India, and Avinash Pandey is sitting here now, he'll bear me out. The reason is gatekeeping costs are prohibitively high, which is the amount of carriage that channels pay. Now, who's paying for that carriage? The advertisers are paying for that carriage. You know, if you have, bulk of the channels are free to air. If you are free to air, you will create sensational content because you are chasing eyeballs at any cost. But if you are a pay channel, you have to deliver well-crafted value which consumers will pay for. And what is it that consumers will pay for? And that is where cricket, or not just cricket in particular, but live sport opens the doors for you. And that is what we are delivering today. Because to look at the future and to look at viability of medium, sport really, really helps you cut that clutter and get distribution. And distribution in many ways. The IPL is one example that it happens every year. We are just about, in a few days, about to launch the tender for the BCCI rights, which is when India plays international cricket in India. And that is going to unfold over the next couple of months. Now, what happens there? This year, India is touring most of the time. In the last 1.5 years, you've seen we played at home. So we're in South Africa now. In the summer, we are going to England. And in the winter, we go to Australia. So the first meaningful big series will only happen in 19. But there will be a company which will be the next rights holder of the BCCI bilateral rights on the 1st of April. What will that company do? It will start, bulk of the distribution deals happen 3 years, 5 years. You can start monetizing that deal, even your actual payout to us will start much later. You go to Tata Sky, you're doing a 3 year deal or a 5 year deal, and you tell him, boss, you want cricket? You write the check now, even though for the next 1 year you have no cricket whatsoever, but you can start monetizing it. That is the power of cricket, and that is where the cricket rights or the cricket content becomes so much important, that today it is the clutter-breaking content. It is the content that can, that is your passport to the future. And vis-a-vis competition from other genres, these days I don't follow them, so they need to figure out what they want to do to cut the clutter and be future ready. But we were hearing about Twitter just now. If you look at the number of Twitter followers that the cricketing stars have vis-a-vis the other stars in this country, they are far bigger. If you look at the number of Twitter followers that BCCI or IPL have, vis-a-vis the various, the biggest channels, we are far bigger. So that is where, that will give you a sense of what people follow, what is the content that they will go after. And the role that, the other role that cricket is playing is, we, you know, Avinash was talking about rates and ad rates going down and agencies moving on. Well, what is driving the rates up is cricket. And it's playing the role of a leader. It is expanding the market. It is driving up the rates of the market or the valuations of the market. And, you know, I was just saying that we want to reach 500 million people in the first week. When I was in Discovery, we had an interesting metric that whenever there was a cricket match, our ratings went up. The reason for that was the overall population of television sets was higher, so you had a higher propensity of catching more viewers. And so we are expanding the market. Now, if somebody else has good content and can hook it, that is the time. A lot of people delay their big launches to after the IPL. I know we disrupt completely. And my former companies launched entertainment channels a few days back. I was telling them you should have launched it after the IPL. We'll mess up with all your budgets. But this is the time that, you know, when the overall population of television sets is on, you can go and do something. And so we will play the role of leaders. We will play the role of expanding the market, of really growing it big time. And the thought process is big. The idea behind it is big. And we want to reach everybody. I mean, one of the things for the IPL that we are doing this time, and I'm sure in the star presentations you would have seen, is it's in 6 languages, but on 6 different channels. So you don't have to figure out how to switch the language on the channel. So that is where it is going. Plus, we are training commentators today. We handle the commentators. We are training commentators in different languages and getting them really up to speed on the look and feel of each channel, how to address each audience. I was telling Mr. Gavaskar that we need to have a session of commentators. And he said, why? I said, because 70% of India was born after you retired. So we need to start thinking differently, and we need to work differently. So that is the role we will play. And to end, I would just say that on the topic of today, was BCCI versus GEC, I don't think there's any match in that. We'll win hands down every day. So thank you very much.
Well, thank you, sir. Mr. Rahul, if I may please request you to come back on stage. And I'd like to invite Mr. Vinash Pandey, the COO of ABP News Network, to please come on stage to present a token of gratitude to our final speaker for the evening, Mr. Rahul Johri. Thank you once again.
You know, Avinash showed you. Yes, yeah. But you know, I would, on the aside, I would tell you, he showed a picture of a man called Nando Paradu. Google him, think about him. He's a guy, he's one of the survivors of the Andes. I met him 10 years back. He's one of the most incredible stories that you will ever see unfolding. He was a guy in his jeans and t-shirt who was on the Andes mountain, and he always says, have you ever been in a freezer? I was in my jeans and t-shirt in temperature lesser than a freezer for whatever number of days he was there.
But people to watch alive on either Netflix.
Correct.
Or,
okay, so I'll plug it in, alive. You read the book, Survival in the Andes.
By the way, the ex-NGC guy here, he'll bail me out. NGC tried...
You like to say that on the mic, sir?
To survive, with the mountain gear, to survive on that mountain for a week. And they could not do it.
Mm.
He survived there for 1.5 months.
Shall see that.
Thank you very much, sir.